pray. Lord our God, you have given us the true bread from heaven. In the strength of this food, may we live always by your life and rise in glory on the last day. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name, blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be his most sacred heart, blessed be his most precious blood, blessed be Jesus in the most holy of the world. May the Holy Spirit be paraclete, blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels, his saints.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Shrine of St. Anthony. Please stand as we pray the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Together, let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. And now let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Wherefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all of the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who from living and chosen stones prepare an eternal dwelling for your majesty, increase in your church the spirit of grace you have bestowed, so that by new growth your faithful people may build up the heavenly Jerusalem. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a wise master builder, I laid a foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it. For no one can lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely Jesus Christ. Do you know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God which you are is holy. The word of the Lord. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not though the earth be shaken and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst, it shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia.
I have chosen and consecrated this house, says the Lord, that my name may be there forever. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers, and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves he said, take these out of here, and stop making my father's house a marketplace. His disciples recalled the words of Scripture, zeal for your house will consume me. At this the Jews answered and said to him, what sign can you show us for doing this? Jesus answered and said to them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. The Jews said, this temple has been under construction for 46 years. And you will raise it up in 3 days? But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the scripture and the words Jesus had spoken. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a short reflection. So let us see why Jesus acted as he did in today's gospel. His anger is a terrifying thing, and the picture of Jesus with the whip is an awe-inspiring sight. We must see what moved Jesus to this white-hot anger in the temple courts. And there were at least a few reasons why Jesus acted as he did and why anger was in his heart. So firstly, he acted as he did because God's house was being desecrated. In the temple, there was worship without reverence. And reverence is an instinctive thing. And worship without instinctive reverence can be a terrible thing. It may be worship which is, for example, formalized and pushed through anyhow. The most dignified prayers on earth can be read like a passage from the phone book. It may be worship which does not realize the holiness of God, and it may be worship in which leader or congregation are completely unprepared. It may be the use of the house of God for purposes and in the way where reverence and true function of God's house are forgotten. In that court of God's house at Jerusalem, there would be arguments about prices, disputes about coins that were worn and thin, the clutter of a marketplace. That particular form or irreverence may not be common now, but there are other ways of offering an irrelevant worship to God. Secondly, Jesus acted as he did in order to show that animal sacrifices were completely irrelevant. For centuries, there was a choir of prophetic voices telling people that the sheer irreverency of the burnt offerings and animal sacrifices, which smoked continuously upon the altar at Jerusalem. And Jesus acted as he did to show that no sacrifice of any animal can ever put a person right with God. We are not totally free from this very tendency today. True, we will not offer animal sacrifice to God, but we can identify his service with the installation of stained glass windows, the obtaining of more sonorous organ, the lavishing of money on stone, and a carved wood, while real worship is far away. It is not that these things are to be condemned, far from it. They are often the lovely offerings of the loving heart, but they are aids to true devotion, and they are God-blessed things, and when they are substitutes for true devotion, they make God sick at heart. And finally, there is still another reason why Jesus acted as he did. Mark has a curious little addition, which none of the other Gospels has. My house shall be called the house of prayer for all the nations. The temple consisted of a series of courts, but all buying and selling was going on in the court of the Gentiles, which was the only place into which a Gentile might come. Beyond that point, access to him was barred. So then, if there was a Gentile whose heart God had touched, he might come into the court to meditate and pray. But the temple authorities and the Jewish traders were making this court into some kind of an uproar and a rubble where nobody could pray and worship. The conduct in the temple court shut out the seeking Gentile from the presence of God. It may well be that this was most in Jesus' mind. It may well be that Mark alone presented the little phrase which means so much. Jesus was moved to the depths of his heart because seeking persons were being shut out from the presence of God. Is there anything in our church life like a snobbishness, an exclusiveness, a coldness, a lack of welcome, a tendency to make the congregation into a closed club, an arrogance which keeps the seeking stranger out? Let us remember the wrath of Jesus against those who made it difficult and even impossible for the seeking stranger to make contact with God. Amen. And now let us stand, relying on our companionship with San Anthony, seeker of the lost. Let us now look heavenward to find in God an answer to all our prayers.
For the Vicar of Christ, our Pope, that his search for unity in the Church and among all peoples of the world might build up the kingdom of God, let us pray to the Lord. For those who have lost their faith amidst the doubts and uncertainties of modern life, especially our own family members and acquaintances, let us pray to the Lord. For all of the sick, especially those whom we mention now in silence, that their health might be restored. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the missing children of the world, and for all those children who have been abandoned, orphaned, or abused, let us pray to the Lord. For persons caught in the grip of addictive disorders, that they might find amazing grace to walk the difficult road of recovery, let us pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed and all the dead, especially those who have lost their lives ill prepared to meet God, let us pray to the Lord. For the intentions of our companions of Saint Anthony, let us pray to the Lord.
God in heaven, you have taught us to seek and find in you the salvation of all life's needs. Please hear the prayers we offer now at the Saint Anthony's intercession through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, the offering made here, and grant that by it those who seek your favor may receive in this place the power of the sacraments and the answer to their prayers. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift
them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of a virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bounds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign, forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy.
We realize that many of you who are watching the Mass on video cannot receive the body and blood of Christ. So we'd like to share this prayer, an act of spiritual communion, with you. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who chose to foreshadow for us the heavenly Jerusalem through the sign of your church on earth, grant, we pray, that by our partaking of this sacrament we may be made the temple of your grace and may enter the dwelling place of your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And today we are praying week 5 of San Anthony Novena. Let us pray together. Anthony, through your teaching and preaching, you bore witness to the loving presence of God in all creation. Now that you have come into the fullness of the kingdom, pray for us that our lives may be yours to proclaim good news of grace, Christ, to all whom. Pray for us, San Anthony. Almighty eternal God, you have given your people, San Anthony, as an outstanding preacher and intercessor in times of need. Grant that with his help we may follow the example of Christian living and experience your support in all our adversities. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we are praying week 5. San Anthony, seeker of the lost, help us to find what is missing in our lives, whatever it is, religion, or spirit of hope. San Anthony, you raised your voice in praise of God and lead others to acclaim his name. Let us pray. O God, may you be glorified by our companionship with San Anthony, the friar, priest, and a doctor of the Gospels. Through the 13 weeks of prayers, we may be renewed in faith, hope, and charity. We ask this with confident trust, that through the intercession of San Anthony, you will bring us the rewards of eternal life promised by Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
through the intercession of San Anthony, the doctor and patron of the church, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.